Agent Lochner, were we able to shake those Nazis? Are we clear?
Yes, Agent Beer, I believe we're clear. By the way, why are we dressed as firefighters again?
Because we have disguised our armored vehicle to look like a fire truck to confuse the enemy. And mostly because my daughter is only 2 and doesn't have any army toys yet. Look out! Over there! On the left! Nazis!
Pew pew! Pew pew! Pew pew!
Nice
pew,
one. Pew. Good shot, Agent Lochner.
Let's check in with Commander Kruger. Commander, come in. Can you hear us? This is Agent Lochner along with Agent Buer. We have finished our assignment and await your orders in occupied France. Do you copy?
Yes, I copy. Though I'm not really sure why I'm dressed like this.
It's because Agent Beer's daughter is only 2.
I'm still not sure that I understand, but there's no time. Agent Lochner, Agent Buer, I'm glad you survived your mission. There have been some updates to our situation. We have received intel that Nazis are attempting to infiltrate our headquarters. I don't have to remind you of the types of experiments we're working on. If they are able to somehow, the results could be catastrophic. How soon can you procure a boat and return to Britain?
We should be able to be there by tomorrow.
Agent Lochner, on the right!
Pew, 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 pew.
That was a close one. Commander Kruger, Agents Lochner and Buer, over and out. Agent Buer, how far until we reach the English Channel?
It's just up ahead. Hold on. You were right. That boat doesn't appear to be occupied, but we'll have to jump for it.
On my mark. 1, 2, 3.
We should make it to headquarters by morning.
Commander Kruger's log, April 24th. The world is in chaos. Headquarters has been destroyed by a horrific act of terrorism. We suspect it to be the Third Reich. Just before the explosion, our sensors detected a contaminant being released through the ventilation systems, resulting in catastrophic mutations of all our agents. I, too, have been contaminated. I am trying to maintain my normal state, but without warning, the transformation overtakes me.
Explosion. There was a contaminant. We have suffered severe mutations. I wonder, how is Agent Lochner and Agent Buer surviving this great tragedy? Agent, are you there? Can you help us?
Oh, phew. Hi. So, as you've seen, a lot of people, especially Commander Kruger, have sacrificed a lot for the sake of global security. We are deep in World War II, and if you've been following 1940s pop culture, you'll know that this has been an era of many genetic mutants, some of whom are considered superheroes, such as my buddy Cap. And we are out trying to make the world a safer place for humans. So today I am back in Great Britain. I am collecting intel on their warplane technology, specifically their fighter planes. Up until this point, their fighter planes haven't been able to accompany their bombers on their full mission. Their fighter planes just don't have the range. But they are working with the U.S. to acquire the P-51 Mustangs. These planes are amazing because they have external tanks on their wings, which lets them to get much further into enemy territory. I'm here now because we just got word that Great Britain is actually putting Rolls-Royce Merlin 61 engines in these Mustangs. We're here to check out this new technology, 430 miles per hour at 30,000 feet.
Thank you, Agent Lochner. This is where the trains stop. I'm not sure what yet happens inside, but it can't be anything good. By the way, next time you see your friend Cap, tell him thanks a lot for ruining my life. I wanted to be Captain United States. I had already bought my costume. But no, Captain America's cooler. He's got a shield that he throws around. This is cool. This is sharp. This hurts people. I'm cool. All the cool names were taken, so I went with Captain B. Why don't I look like a bee? I had already bought the costume. It was too late to return it. I'm not made out of money. Thanks a lot, Captain America. I hate you. Low grade. We're on the same side, fighting the Nazis, so that's okay. Anyway, hopefully with the use of my superpowers, I'll be able to get in and out. What are my superpowers, you ask? Number one, I can stand in front of a room full of people and turn completely invisible. Nobody will see me. They'll be looking at their hands. They'll be talking with their neighbors. I turn completely invisible. Number two, when I do get somebody to listen to my voice, they slowly find themselves drifting off to sleep. It doesn't matter if it's 10 a.m. in the morning. You know who you are. All right, the odds are long. Nobody's ever made it out of there alive. Am I scared? Yes. Does that make me a hero? Maybe greater than Captain America? Some would say so. I can't say that. But I think they're right. Wish me luck. 6 feet.